Hello, today we are going to discuss about planning, the fundamentals of management. First, we will start with defining what is planning. First, let's understand what is plan. A plan is a blueprint for action. It is a specific, like what will be the resource allocation, what will be the schedule. Schedules means the timeline through which we are going to achieve the desired plan. What will be the different actions necessary for attaining the goals? A goal is a desired future state that an organization attempts to realize. So plan is a mean of attaining our goal. And the planning is the act of determining organization's goal and the means for achieving them. So we'll find that goal, plan and planning is all interrelated and all tries to get what is intended, desired outcome for the future. So why is planning important for managers? Planning is very important for managers because of different reasons. We will discuss some of basic here to determine new opportunities. Through planning, managers can determine what are the new opportunities in the field which can be tapped for the better benefit which can be the organization can get in future. To anticipate and avoid future problems, planning is also a means to avoid any trouble or future problems that can arise in due course of the development. To develop effective course of action, planning is also a very good tool for making good strategies and tactics which can be implemented for attaining the goals of organization. To comprehend the uncertainties and risk with various options. So in planning, we have different options for attaining our goals. So during the course of the planning, we can judge and optimize which options will be good for attaining the goal with minimum risk. It will also help in setting up standards for our planning for our future goals. So first, we will see that the hierarchy of the plans. First, there will be a mission statement. This will be the core goals of the organization, of the institution. Then at the top management level, there will be strategic goals, plans, that is the top senior most management of the organization do. And then at the middle management division, there will be tactical goals, plans. This will be more about attaining the divisional goals, departmental goals. Like there will be different department in the organization, like there will be planning, publishing, there might be advertising. So different department will try to attain their goals through setting of tactical goals. Then at the lower level, at a departmental or individual level, there will be operational goals, plans, which will be implemented by lower managements, like overseers, like the team leaders. They will implement at individuals level. It will be just for judging the performance of the individual and for attaining the desired outcome. This will be also for a shorter period of time, because for ascertaining the efficiency of the department or individual or attaining a goal, it will be just like say within one day, within 1 week, or maximum 1 month. So it will be short terms. We have discussed the mission statement, strategic goals, tactical goals, and operational goals. These are the different levels of the management. And now we will discuss about the organizational detail. There will be some detail. So the mission is the organization's reason for existence. They have a mission, the mission statement. Every organization will have a very mission statement that, like, for what purpose, the what value they want to deliver to the customers. So the mission describes the organization's values and aspirations. The mission statement is a broad statement defining the organization's basic business scope, operations, that distinguishes it from its competitor, you can say. So every organization will have a unique statement, unique value delivery system. So mission statement will have three components: what business are we in, what are we, what we are doing. So it will tell the customers what the business we are doing, who we are, what is our team, how we are going to deliver the value, and what value we are creating, what product we are creating, what value are we are delivering. So organization mission, our mission is to be the world premier consumer product. So like some company will have focused on convenient food and beverage. We seek to produce financial reward to investors, is provide opportunity for growth and enrichment to our employees, our business partners, and the community in which we operate. In everything we do, we strive for honesty, fairness, and integrity. So different organizations will have different mission, but it will be the ultimate goal that the organization want to attain. So what will the strategic plan? Strategic plans defines the action or steps taken by which the organization intend to achieve its goal. Strategic goals are broad goals of where the organization wants to be in future. These goals pertain to the whole organization, not individual. So these are strategic plans are made by top management, and the strategic goals are the key planning steps taken for attaining the mission of the organization. So now let's discuss about the tactical plans. You know, the tactical plans are planned to help the organization execute its strategies, its goals, to execute its strategic goals and to accomplish a specific part of the company's strategy. So tactical goals will be the implementation of the strategy at a departmental level. Tactical goal defines the outcome of that major division or department must achieve in order to reach its goal. So it will be the complementing to the organizational strategic goals. So let's understand what are the basic difference between the strategic goals and tactical goals or plans. Strategic are ensure long-term effective growth, but tactical is used as mean to implement strategic plans. Usually 2 or more years, strategic plans are for longer period, but tacticals are shorter period. Strategic plans are done every 1 to 3 years, it can be 5 years. But tactical plans are done every 6 months to a year. So it will be short-term plans. Strategic planning is done by top management, but tactical planning is done by the employees who are at the middle management level. It is done by middle management managers. Then comes operational plans. These plans are specific, major departmental results. Operational plans are usually done on a daily or weekly basis. Operational plan defines the outcome of a division or department. It also defines how efficient the division or department is, how efficiently the employees are delivering the value to the organization. Operational goals can be like visit 1 customer each day, have machine downtime less than 7%. So there can be different, but it should be measurable within a specific time frame. So there can be different plans: single use plan, standing plans, and contingency plans. We will discuss them in some detail in next slides. Single use plans for attaining one time organizational goal, large in scope, Like single use plants, they have a larger scope, like building a new headquarter, installing new accounting system, projects are included. So this is single use. If you make new headquarter, then for next few years, you don't have to think about new headquarters. If you are installing new accounting system, then you don't have to think about different accounting system for the one, at least 1 year, because there should be compliance of the accounting system. So for it is long term, because it is single use. Projects included in this category of planning are mostly expansion, like for this year we want to have this number of computers, this type of softwares. Standing plans are ongoing plans that are used to provide guidance for tasks performed repeatedly within an organization. In the standing plans, you will find that there will be different policy, sexual harassment policy. There will be different board organized for board for looking into grievances of the employees. Based on organizational goals, there can be different policy. There will be different rules, like there is no smoking in the class, narrow, defined, specific. There will be, the rules will be specific. There might be some procedures also. In a standing class, you will find there is some procedures, like what will the procedures when employees want to file any grievance. Define precise series of the steps to attain certain goals. Contingency plan. Plans that define company response to a specific situation, for example, emergency or unexpected condition. Contingency plan is actually a plan which is implemented when there is abnormal condition, when there is not, when the company is going through abnormal situation, there is some emergency, there is some strike, some, so there will be contingency plan. Now we will discuss about the strategic management. A strategy is a plan of action that prescribes resource allocation and activities for dealing with the environment, achieving the competitive advantage, and attaining organizational goals. So we'll find that top management persons, they devise a strategy for attaining the mission of the organization. Strategy management is a set of decisions or actions used to formulate and implement strategies that will provide a competitive superior fit between the organization and its environment to achieve organizational goal. So there can be different type of strategies, like grand strategies, this is a broad level, growth strategy, how we are going to expand our business, stability strategy, how we are going to keep our income stable for a longer period of time. Retrenchment strategy, global strategy. We can have global strategy, like how we are going to expand in the different countries. Multi-domestic strategy. There can be transnational strategy. So there are different strategies which can be implemented. Grand strategy, a general plan of major action by which an organization intends to achieve its long-term goals. It can be internal, like the development of new product, expansion of new product or services in a new market, or it can be diversification, acquisition and mergers. What is diversification? Diversification is the expansion in a new field, and acquisition is the acquiring a competitive industry which can supplement our income or growth. Merger is acquisition where two companies merge together and work as a single entity. Stability strategy, maintaining the same size of organization or growth slowly in a controlled fashion. So we want to keep stability, stable income, stable growth of the organization over a period of time. Retrenchment strategy, The organization is forced to reduce its size by selling off business unit or liquidation entire business. So there will be retrenchment strategy as well. Liquidation is the terminating of a business unit by selling the business unit to cash value of its asset. Divestiture, selling business unit that is no longer considered central to the organization. So at one hand, we can have diversification, we can expand. At the other hand, when we find that some unit of our organization is not making profit, then we can dissolve it, we can liquidate it. So there will be a global strategy, standardization of the product design, advertising strategy throughout the world. Treats world as single market. This is one of the major its strategy for promotion of the brand. If you want to make a global brand, then you have to standardize your process of the product design. You have to standardize your logo, your slogan, your trademark. So these are the some of the strategies which can be implemented at a global level. They call me multinational strategy, like modification of the product design and advertising strategy to suit the specific need of individual country. Like if we want to promote a product in India, then we have to adopt, convert the language interface into Hindi, other prominent language like Tamil, Telugu, Bengali, if we want to have deeper penetration in the Indian market. So in the different countries, there might be different context. There might be language, there might be some cultural barriers. So we have to absorb, how we can dilute that barrier and make our product penetrate in that market. Transnational strategy. A transnational strategy seeks to achieve global integration, national responsiveness. The objective is to attain efficiency and flexibility to meet a specific need in various countries. So like in some low-income countries, we have to provide cheap prices. We have to reduce the prices. We can provide an alternative product which have lower value, which is value for the money. So in different country, we will have to change the interface of the language input. So transnational strategy seeks to achieve global integration and national responsiveness, which means we have to adopt our product and services according to the need, a specific need of the different country. There are different level of strategy: corporate level strategy, business level strategy, and functional level strategy. So at the top, there will be corporate level strategies. What business we are in? Like Edupedia publication is in the business of publication, printing. So there will be business strategies also. How we are going to compete with other publishing companies, other companies. Then there might be other functional level strategies. Like how do we support the business level strategy? How we are going to capture a particular market? So there will be different strategies at different level. At corporate level strategy, which will pertain to whole organization, the business unit, product line. So at the corporate level, we will talk about how we are going to brand our products, our business, how we are going to venture into different fields. It will ask question, what business we are in? What are your focus? What are our strength? What are our unique selling price? But at the business level strategy, it will pertain to each business unit or product line. Like a company, there will be different product. So at business level, every individual product, they will have individual strategy. Focus on how the business unit compete with the industry for customer. So business level strategies are concerned with the following: advertising, product change, new product line development, equipment and facilities. Business level strategies put out competitive force. So one of the theory is Porter's competitiveness forces. So what is this? There will be rivalry among competitors. What will be the base of the competition? There will be the potential new entrant. There will be fear that new entrant might enter in the business. There will be bargaining power of the buyers. Like buyers will ask you to give concession, discount, give them waiver. There might be bargaining power of the suppliers. Like we can say that our product is very unique. We deliver the best of the services, best value to your money. So there can be bargaining by the suppliers as well. There will be threat of substitute product. Like there will be inferior product they can substitute. Like in the case of a herbal product, you will find that there was Dabur, Unilever products, but now Patanjali product are substituting those products. So there might be, there are four competitive forces which will be always there for the competitors. Its functional level strategy pertains to the organization's function department, finding way to how support the business level strategy. So functional level strategies will support the business level strategy, and the business level strategy will support the corporate level strategy. So you will see that functional level strategy are the lowest level of the strategy, which will be department specific, like finance, research and development, marketing, manufacturing. Strategic management process. So here we will study what is the management process. So in the strategic management process, we first have to evaluate current mission, goal and strategy of the business. Then we have to scan external environment in which we are operating, and then we have to scan internal environment, and then we have to redefine our goals, mission and grand strategy so that we can formulate strategies and then implement them so that we can attain our new modified mission, goals and strategy. Thank you for listening.